What's up, YouTube? Coach Jim here. Welcome back for another edition of Busting Cards. And today, I'm pretty excited about today's episode, actually, because today is my first mail time video. And so we finally, you know, you guys, if you guys have seen our other videos, you know, we just got back into card collecting. So, you know, starting to get some more cards for the collection and getting stuff in that you know, we're finding interesting. So I want to take some time and share some of that with you. And as you know, we just got back from our trip from Nashville to Orlando, and now we're back home. And you can see we've back at our normal setup. And so that was a fun trip. And while we were there, we did get some stuff. So before we go into the mail, I'm going to just show you some of the things we got. Met a couple of nice, really decent guys, card shop owners in Orlando, a couple in Nashville area as well. So we just picked up a couple of things there. Some of it we opened on video, so you can go to those videos and check it out. But what I want to show you now, just some stuff that we got for our personal collections, and nothing spectacular, nothing fancy, but just some stuff that's special to us. So we got, you know, a Logan Thomas Tops or Totally Certified rookie card. Really nice card there. We got a Logan Thomas three-color patch, Inception. And that one is numbered to 75. So Logan Thomas, number 75. And Logan, if you guys know who Logan Thomas is, he started out as a quarterback, drafted for the Cardinals. Then he went on and played in some other spots. Ended up landing in Buffalo. Currently, he's at Buffalo, and they've transferred him from quarterback to tight end. So he's like the third string tight end there. But he gets some playing time. He's a really talented young player. And you may ask, why is he so important and why am I collecting his stuff? But you can see we've got a nice little Logan Thomas autograph patch card, rookie card, so RPA for him. And you know, you may ask, well, Coach Jim, why are you so up on this guy? He's a third string tight end. But you know, Logan, sometimes you collect cards that have some financial importance. Sometimes you collect cards because there's some personal importance, right? Logan was a young man that I got to coach. I was his first football coach when he was 8 years old. Coached him through middle school, through high school. Love his family. Great kid. Love Logan to death. So, you know, I got a bunch of Logan cards, a bunch of autographs and stuff from him. But when I'm in a store and I see some Logan, you know, I got to grab him because, you know, he's one of my guys. And then picked up some stuff for the personal collection, my 49er collection, and some of my special 49er players. Frank Gore, of course, beast running back for the Niners. Went on to play in Indianapolis, now playing in Miami. But to me, he'll always be a 49er. Wanted to stay there. They didn't work it out, so he had to move on. But just moved into number 4 all-time in rushing. Past Curtis Martin, I think it was, and he's right behind Barry Sanders. I don't know that he'll have enough years left in him to get another 1,000 yards to grab Barry, but that's the one he's in striking distance with, so he could end up number 3 before he retires. But one of my favorite players, and we got a rookie card, a couple of rookie cards from Frank Gore. Picked up a nice Roger Craig. Again, just another one of special players from the Niners back in the day. Add that to the collection. We got a bunch of Rice cards. Huge Rice fan. So Jerry's my guy. And just picked up a bunch of his cards. Got the greatest of all time head-to-head with Chris Carter. Two all-time great receivers there. A couple parallels in unparalleled. Kind of funny you say unparalleled and there's so many parallels in it. But you know, just adding those to the Rice collection. And I picked up just a Montana card I happened to see. Actually, I think my wife found this one and said, hey, you should get this one too. It's in his Kansas City days, but you can see up over my head somewhere back there is my Kansas City helmet with Montana's signature on it. So this will just go nice with that. And yeah, I did have a 49er helmet, but my son now has that at his home because I promised him when he got his own home, he could have that. So I relinquished it. I wasn't happy about it, but, you know, you do some strange things for family. So that's what we picked up, just some personal cards and things for the collection. And now let's get to the stuff that came into the mail. So shouldn't be a long video today. Just got a couple of things, and we'll start with some eBay purchases. And again, nothing special, but special to us. But we did pick up a couple of Dante Pettis cards. And I got these for my daughter's personal collection because she is a Dante Pettis fan. And so figure, well, these were on there, and I liked what I saw. So we got the Dante Pettis New Generation from Certified, and that was numbered to $3.99. And actually, this came with a package because I bought the autograph, Rookie Titanium Autograph, Dante Pettis, numbered to 350. Really a nice-looking card here. I just like the way that bronze look, that titanium look with the plate, autographs on the plate. It's a really nice setup, and I know she'll enjoy those too. So I picked those up for her. And the next one, another eBay purchase, I think from the same seller. We picked up another Dante Pettis card, and this one was National Treasures, University of Washington. The item in his Washington uniform, big patch, two-color patch. See the gold stripe there, and nice on-card signature. I don't think this one is numbered. It's not numbered. Oh no, it is numbered. Numbered to 99. See it right here. I almost missed it. Numbered to 99. So. A couple of really nice Dante Pettis rookie card autographs. She'll enjoy those in her collection. And then next is my first break results. So I've got into a break. Haven't done a break before. This was the first time I've ever done a break. Again, getting back into the swing of collecting. And back when I was collecting, case breaks, box breaks, none of that existed. So that's all, you know, brand new to me. And decided I wanted to check it out. Wasn't sure where I wanted to go. And then I saw Packer Cards 87 was doing a special break for viewers of his channel. And he was doing it with a company called Buck City Breaks. So I decided, well, let's jump into it. If he's going to promote it, I like what he's doing. So let's get into that break. And man, I got to tell you, if you're looking to do a break, whether you're new to it and you haven't done one, I highly recommend you check it out. It's a good way to spend less money, but still be able to take advantage of some of the more expensive hobby boxes that are out there. In this case, it was a Spectra break. Spectra boxes run about $285 or so per box. I got into a half case break. That's what this is from, is a half case break. So they took half the boxes in the case. They broke them open. You bought a team and you got whatever cards that were of that team. You get to keep. So it's a pretty good setup. Buck City Breaks are the guys that Packer Cards set up the break with. And I got to tell you, man, nothing but respect and love for those guys. They're building a community around what they're doing. And I can't tell you enough how much I would recommend that company and those guys to do a break with. So if you're looking to jump into one, you haven't done it, or if you have done them before, but you haven't done it with these guys, you should check them out. Buck City Breaks. Just look them up. Go to their site. See what they've got going on. They do some really nice stuff. And they're great, great guys. So these are some of the things we got. So what we did was, I think I bought the 49ers first. My daughter was talking about picking up a team. So she went and got the Eagles in the same break. And then while we were in there, we got the Rams too. So we ended up with the 49ers, the Rams, and the Eagles, and these are the cards that we got from them. So first off, pull these out of here. I'll slide this, oops, knocked over Joe Montana, and Joe's there for a reason. You'll see why in a second. But the first card we got was Eagles. So my daughter grabbed this one out of the break. It's a Brian Dawkins and Epic Legends. So as we know, Brian Dawkins just went into the Hall of Fame. And Spectra did a Legends card with him. Nice little patch. And this one's numbered to $199. So that was a good little pickup. And then we picked up for the Rams an autograph, John Kelly. And this is rookie autographs. And this one is numbered. I think all of these cards are numbered. This one's numbered to $149. And just a nice, you know, John Kelly rookie card for the Rams. And we picked up a die cut Rams Brandon Cooks. Nice die cut card in the shape of the S for Spectra. And that one was numbered to 35. So low print card there. Numbered 35 die cut Spectra for Brandon Cooks. Nice little pickup. And then we picked up Cornerstones. We got the Jared Goff Cornerstones. Decent sized patch here. Nice looking, beautiful card. And then this one was numbered to 99. So out of that break for the Rams, we got the three hits. And then we got the for the Eagles, the Brian Dawkins Epic Legends. So not bad. And then the piece de resistance dance. I don't know if I said that right. Don't really care. But we got one more card. And this one was for the Niners. And man, I am stoked about this card. I can't tell you. First break, and to hit a card like this, I know I'm teasing, but to hit a card like this is pretty spectacular. And when they said it, actually it's funny, because if you go back and watch the video of this break, and Buck City has it on their YouTube channel, so you should check it out. But yeah, you see the card in front of it slide, and I could just see the corner of it, and I knew it was a Niner. And I started getting excited. And when they peeled it back, because nothing else giant had been pulled out of this set. And when they started sliding it back, I could see what it was. And I literally was sitting in a hotel room watching this video. And I freaked out, man. I was shaking. I was yelling. My wife was like, what in the world's going on? The guys on the YouTube channel, they were screaming about it. So just a cool, cool hit. And honestly, for the first break, way more than I expected. But we actually got a Super Bowl champion signature series autographed by Joe Montana. And as you know, huge 49er fan, everything Joe Montana. This was just ridiculous to me. I cannot tell you how excited I was when this card came out of that box. And to know it was coming to me, it was just incredible. And that's numbered to 25. So super low print, nice card. Great, great signature. That's a perfect Joe Montana signature. All on the card, and it's an on-card autograph, number to 25. So I'd say that was a pretty good hit, pretty good break for us. And super excited about how that one turned out. So there you have it. That's all I've got for today to show. But, man, I just want to say again, if you are in the market for a break and you don't know where to go, or you haven't done one yet, or if you've been breaking for a while but you haven't checked these guys out, you should check out Buck City Breaks. Packer Cards 87, great, great job. They've built a community. Bring you in, man. They make you feel like you're part of the family right away, and they give you really cool stuff like this. So there you go. Until the next time, go grab some packs, bust them open, see what you get.